was working on the cash register. So I was scared. I'm a man. Gang, what it is, Yani squad. Welcome back to my channel. Welcome back to my new video. Y'all read the title. Y'all see I'm gonna be talking about basically what it's like to work at Burlington. All the things you need to know about working at Burlington before you work at Burlington. Is it a good place to work? Is it a good first job? All of those subjects. What to expect working on the cash register. All of that. I'm gonna be covering all of that. So let's get right into the video. Quick story time. Before I started working in Burlington, I was just looking at videos and I'm just like, oh my God, I'm scared to work on the cash register because, oh my God, I really don't like handling people money. And I was just so scared out of my mind. So I'm just looking at videos trying to see, like, is it going to be hard? Like, what am I supposed to expect? And I couldn't find that. So I had to take a leap of faith and I had to just go and just try it out. So on your first day when you start working at Burlington, you don't really need to expect to do much. All you have to basically do is just go in the back room, go on the computer and do like your computer orientation. So that first day, maybe your first 2 days, not even a full second day, a little over like an hour, y'all. Maybe like an hour of your second day, you will be in there finishing up the paperwork on the computer, all that, telling them all your information, da da da. Then after that second day, they're gonna put you with somebody, and they're gonna have to train you how to work on the cash register, how to work on the sales floor, basically everything, working at the door, markdowns, everything. I'm gonna show you how to do everything. So first thing they trained me to do was work on the cash register. So I was scared. I'm a man. So the girl had to like show me a few times, like handle a few customers. A few times when I came, the thing was like, hello, how you doing? Check them out. Then once you bag all their stuff up and scan all the items, then you checking them out, let them pay and everything. So you had to ask them that they're going to make a donation towards leukemia. So they said no, then just keep on going. Then you ask they paying cash or card, whatever they paying, then you just press it what they paying and continue to go on from there. So she did it like a good 3-4 times, and then it came around and it was my turn, and I had to try it, and I was so scared, and my mind and my heart was racing. I was like, oh my God, I'm so scared. I'm like, I hope this person is not paying cash, because I was so scared. I know how to count and everything, but I was just scared. I didn't know. I was scared that somebody would try to accuse me of giving them back the wrong change, or you know, because you know how people are today, they grimy, they do stuff like that. So thankfully I got the hang of it pretty quick. It's not that hard. You just, if they paying cash, you just type in what they giving you so that it can be like proof or whatever, they gave you this much and all that, and then you get them back the correct amount of change you're supposed to get them, and then it's that. And they print their receipt on the screen and then they could go on about their day. They're paying card, okay, you click F4, they're paying card, enter, let them put their card in the machine, keep on going, let their receipt print out, give it to them, and they can have a nice day. Basically, that's all. It was not even hard at all. I was stressing over nothing the whole time. I was stressing over nothing. So y'all don't have to stress. If you scared to work at Burlington, don't be. It's not that hard. It's really simple. It's really easy. It is not hard at all. Coming from me, out of anybody, it is not hard. So other things, the next thing, working on the sales floor. Basically what you're doing on the sales floor all day is going whatever section they put you in. Say if they put you in men's, you have to recover men's clothes, Say if they put you a men's sportswear. Let me just be specific. Men's sportswear. You have to recover all of the men's clothes. Go row by row. Make sure nothing is facing the wrong way. Everything is on a hanger. Nothing is on the floor. Nobody's just threw clothes over the rack. You know how people be having clothes hanging over the rack and not hanging up on the rack? Make sure it's not. Make sure everything is neat and tidy. You have to keep doing that until it's time for you to go. And sometimes it gets annoying. It really does get annoying because you have to continue to keep fixing and cleaning up after customers because they keep coming and they keep messing it up. But y'all, it will get easy for you. Some days it's just like, this ain't gonna never get easy because it's just like you have to continue to keep coming back and correcting what customers have done wrong. Like, you never know what it feels like to work in retail until you're working at retail. When you be like, I don't want this no more. You just sit it anywhere and you're like, whatever. And don't do that, y'all. Don't do that because they have to come and they have to get what you just threw anywhere and put it back where it belongs all day long. Whoever's on the sale, so that's what we're doing all day long, cleaning up. If you put something where it does not belong, you have to take it to where it does belong, because just making sure it's nice and neat. So like, if the bosses come, they come, they don't have to say anything to your manager about how the store is looking because you didn't do your job. You didn't clean up, make sure everything was where it's supposed to be. Clothes ain't all over the place. Shoes ain't all over the place, especially in shoes. Shoes be all over the floor because customers try on shoes all day long and they don't want it. And they just leave them on the floor. They don't even put it back where it belongs. So you have to pick all them shoes up and put them back on the rack. Put them exactly where their shoe size is supposed to be at. And it might take long, but it's okay. You have time. You're going to be there 8 hours. Trust me, you have time. You'll finish it. And it'll all be worth it at the end because it looks so nice and neat and tidy. It's not a hard job. I would recommend Burlington to be a first-time job for teens. Anybody who's never worked before, I would recommend Burlington to be your first job experience. So that's the sales floor. Okay, let me do accessories. If you're in accessories, basically it's the purses, the jewelry, the belts, the sunglasses, scarves, hats, all of that stuff. You basically making sure all that stuff is nice and tidy and neat where it's supposed to go. And just continuing to fix everything up. So the next thing is basically doing working at the front door. Basically, all you're doing is sitting there greeting customers when they come in the door. Basically, hello, how you doing? Thank you for coming to Burlington. Cleaning off carts. Customers come to you, ask you where to find some things. Basically, you're just greeting customers at the door. You're making sure the carts are put back. Cleaning them off every time a customer gets done with it because it's COVID right now. So that's basically what you're doing at the front door. You're just being a greeter and cleaning off carts and all the other things that customers use on a day. I mean, they can do it themselves, but most people don't even, they just come in and they just grab the cart because they think that we're cleaning it, so we might as well clean it. So we clean it for them. Some people just clean it double because they don't know if we're cleaning it or not. But sometimes the customer walk in and I'll be wiping off the cart and they'll see that and they're like, can I get that cart? And I just get them the cart. Because they see that we're sanitizing, we're making sure nobody is touching another cart that somebody has already used or touched at all. So that's basically what it's like working at the front door, being the front door ambassador, shortage control, just all the different types of titles that is. So, what else? Markdowns. Markdowns is basically you just make marking down all the things that's been there too long and nobody has bought. So you just go around each section in the store, literally the whole store, until it's time for you to go. And you scan it and you see if it beeps, that means it got marked down. Get the sticker, put the new sticker on that, take whatever it was, put it in the clearance rack, and just keep going until you're done. So that's basically that. It's pretty simple. Working around the center, it's pretty simple. It is not hard at all. It's a great first job, like I said before. As far as your coworkers and everything and mess, I say if you stay to yourself and mind your business and don't start nothing with nobody, just keep quiet to yourself, get your little section of people and, you know, stay to yourself, then you shouldn't really have no problems with mess and drama But I feel like every retail place that you work in will have like some messy people or mess. Me personally, I haven't had no experience where I've got into it with anybody there. Like I said, stay to yourself, mind your business, and don't be in everybody with, you know, you should be fine. But if you were the type of person that be in everybody's business and always got something to stay stuck up, then baby, I don't know what to tell you. I don't think you need to be working at Burlington if that's the type of person that you are. So, what else? The store can be pretty clean at times if the people are doing their jobs. It's not hard at all. That's basically what I wanted to just come on here and say, because I know everybody be scared to start a new job in Burlington and all of that. Burlington is a great place, organization to work, a nice group of friendly people, everybody cool. As far as I know, everybody's been cool to me. Friendly, managers cool, everything. They're you know, they're the manager, they have authority, but they not overstepping their title. You know, I've never had that experience with them. They overstep their title. I'm the manager, you gonna, you know, no, I've never had that experience. Like I said, if you're a respectful person and you just, you know, follow the rules, then you shouldn't really have no problems. What else? I feel like it's something I'm missing that I wanted to say. Y'all. But Burlington has been a really wonderful place to work. And oh, but retail can get annoying at times. Yes, the job is easy, but Burlington is open from 7 a.m. right now to 12 a.m. at night. The Burlington that I'm working in. And it feels like when you work in the closing shift, it feels like you've been there forever. Like you just there forever, because it's just like, shouldn't I be at home in the bed asleep or something like that? And that nature. And you're not, because it's just like that day is going by so slow, because you have to wait till 12 a.m. to go. Literally the next day to leave. And it's all right, y'all. It's not that hard. They do pay $11 an hour right now. I'm not sure if it's going to go up soon or what, but that's what they're paying right now. That's the pay rate. They have really cool people there. Friendly. Need somebody to take your shift, and you just ask around or post your shift. People are cool enough to, like, you know what, I'll help you out. Let me, you know, I'll post my shift. They take your shift. Okay, it's that simple. There's really nothing bad that I could really say about Burlington. Right now, I can't say anything bad about Burlington. I can't think of anything bad I could say about them as a company. Overall, as a company, they're a good place. That's a good place to work. Yeah. But yeah, y'all, don't be afraid of that cash register. Do not be afraid of that cash register. It's going to be okay. It's not that hard. It's not hard at all. Let me correct that. So, thank y'all for watching this video. Make sure you like, comment, subscribe. Tell your friends to subscribe.